Viking.
Otmar's senses had sharpened throughout his journey. He could feel someone was watching him.
"I know you're there, goblin," said Otmar firmly.
"I am not a goblin, Otmar," said the creature and sighed. "I may look like this now, but there was a time when you and I were not that different."
It couldn't be,
could it?
Not only had this creature been helping him all along, but this creature was, in fact, his oldest friend.
"Vaskar?"
The creature protested, but it was no use. Otmar had many questions for his oldest friend, and many stories he wished to relive. Of the time they chased chickens, thinking they were small dragons. Or pretended to be the chief so they could steal desserts. Oh, to have found friendship again, so many years after being alone.
With a sense of shame, Vaskar looked down and said,
"I'm not Vaskar anymore. I've not been since I was cast out. Now I'm even less. I didn't want to tell you because I didn't want you to see me like this."
"Stop it," Otmar interrupted.
"You should have told me. It's okay, I know what's happened to you.
But this time, you're not alone. Together, we can save the forest and save our people." The two friends were reunited, and although their quest was far from over, their spirits were high. Could it be that all was not as bleak as it once appeared?
Whoa!
Ah!
two friends continued further through the forest, getting closer towards the end of their journey.
What was it like to fight the god of chaos?
Asked Odmar.
Oh, we do not speak of him, replied Vaska. He's vain. He loves the stories people tell of him. The words call to him.
Odmar turned to his friend and said, I'm not afraid of Loki. Thunder struck, and the fairy appeared.
Fairy! Said Odmar. The elder told me I needed to ascend a mountain to retrieve a key. A key that opens a gate between worlds.
The fairy paused, her expression twisting. Something was wrong.
The elder lied to you,
said the fairy.
The only way out of this world is death.
This is not the fairy!
Vaska shouted. Odmar stood fast. He would not act.
It's time for you to join your fellow warriors.
The fairy roared in a dark voice. The fairy's eyes turned green, and a bolt of lightning extended towards Odmar. But Vaska leapt in front of his friend, shielding Odmar from the magic. And once again, Odmar had lost his oldest friend.
Vaska, always the hero, wasn't he?
The fairy said nefariously.
I will not give you the honor of joining your friends. I will curse you, just as I cursed Vaska.
Odmar was enraged, but did not know what to do.
I too am cursed, Odmar,
the fairy continued.
My curse is not to sit alongside my fellow gods. They do not accept me, but I aspire to even greater heights. Your people will help me. They will break through the gates of Valhalla for me, so that I may take my rightful place. I am the greatest god, for I am the god of chaos. I am Loki.
In a flash, Loki was gone.
Ah! No. Come back.
Thank you.
Ardmar scaled the cliff, alone. His allies were gone, and his heart was broken. Yet he continued to push forward. Loki's curse. It was real. Just as it turned Vaskar, it too would turn him. He would fail the forest and his village. Perhaps, he thought, the world was better off with no Vikings in it. But he would not have to fight alone. For in front of him, he saw a familiar pair of tusks which he didn't expect this far up a mountain. Perhaps all was not lost.
Oh!
Odmar had done it. He had reached the cave the Elder had told him of. He would soon have to face the golem. The fairy was waiting for him at the entrance.
"You've proved yourself,"
said the fairy.
"You've passed the test. I'll return Vaskar to you, and you can rebuild your village free of that tyrant chief and those who judged you so harshly."
Odmar knew this was not the fairy. This was just another deceitful trick by Loki. He was not fooled. Loki shifted into his true form and menacingly said,
"I guess my trick didn't work. You're not as dumb as you look. But then again, maybe the pig is the brains of this operation."
With Loki distracted by the sound of his own voice, his guard was down. This was Odmar's chance. Odmar and his trusted companion charged towards Loki, but were quickly struck down by a bolt of lightning that reflected off Odmar's shield. With the influence of his power, Loki was confident that Odmar would stand no chance against the golem. He used his magic to wake the ancient golem and left Odmar to fight for his life.
Oh!
was over. Ardmar had won. Weary but resolved, he had found the shiny red gem that was the key to saving his people. Ardmar held the key up high and waited for something to happen, but quickly realized he didn't know how to use it. Suddenly, a vicious band of goblins swooped down on Ardmar. He struggled to hold on to the key, but there were too many goblins. Ardmar was overwhelmed. They snatched the key and ran away. Goblins. Their treachery had no limits.